Close to the end of season 8. Right now we move on to Homestead for the penultimate race of the season. Race 31 of the season. And right now let's take a look at the point standings before this race. Let's take a look at it right now, and it's not done properly. You know what? Forget it. Let's show it like that. So here you go. Oh, I've got an idea. Fit the screen. Forget it. Let's do it. Let's do it this way. So yeah. So this is the chase standings right now coming up to this race, and after this race we will find out who will make it on to the final four of the chase. And right now one driver has been confirmed to place onto the final four, and that is Blake Parker, who has won last race back at Phoenix. So he currently leads the point standings right now, and behind him currently is Trey Meeks. The season one champion could be up for his second championship if he can make it onto the final four and hopefully win the championship after this one. So, and behind him, Solomon Sheridan could be another championship in his hands if he does win as well, and he's currently third place. And Drew Walker, also fourth, currently in fourth, and also could be up for winning another championship right now. So, could be up for another championship if he does win. So anyway, so that's, those are the current drivers in the top four. However though, everyone will have a chance, or still have a chance, to try and make it to the top four depending on performance coming up this race. So currently behind the cutoff line, Dylan Hayden in fifth with a win in the bag. Alrighty, Alejo in sixth. I think he has 3 wins in total this season. Jameson with a win in seventh. And Leland Hill, despite winning, I think, 4 to 5 races. I think 5 races. He currently live in third, in eighth, sorry. So, there you go. Those are all the those are how the standings are at the moment coming up to this race. So, but still though, anything can happen, anything can change after this race. So now let's go through the qualifying session, the qualifying session for today's race. Who will qualify on pole for today's race? And it's going to be Leland Hill who will qualify on the pole. Blake Parker, last race winner, will start second place. Roberto Crown Jr. third. Trey Meeks fourth. David Ryans fifth. Solomon Sheridan sixth. Rei Ayanami seventh. Enos Kakia eighth. James Jameson ninth. And Alrighty Alejo tenth. And the rest. And Drew Walker will start last, which is really bad. He needs to up his game if he wants to make it on to the final four, because last race he hadn't scored any points due to a pit stop error or some thought. So yeah, pit stop issues. So right now it's going to be a race against time of who is going to make it onto the final four. We'll find out after Homestead. So now let's get on with it. Let's get on with it right now. Here we go. And hopefully it's much better than the last race. Phoenix was an absolute disaster, with graphics issues and all this. But Homestead is a bit, well, it, we've used Homestead before. We've used this track before in the past couple of races and it's much better. So anyway, as the pace car rolls, as the pace car moves, everyone else are lining up pretty well. And hopefully, maybe if I'm in the mood, or maybe, I don't know, maybe I can try and maybe see if anyone else is willing to co-commentate with me. So right now, we gotta focus on Homestead. It's going to be very important, this race. Of course, people have said that this is a very important race to be, because this will be decided by performance and also the willingness to take a risk. So here we go. So who's willing to take the risk here at Homestead as the race go green and Leland Hill takes off into the lead like he's about to shoot over a car. In fact, Leland Hill is in a much better position right now. Now that he's leading, he could definitely lock into the final four if he can carry on from there. Some cars are swerving a little bit, something to keep an eye on right now. Let's see who is going to make it. Oh, Roberto Crown Jr. He hit the wall. Something he got to be careful about, because otherwise he's gonna cause a problem right now. So, oh, and Jameson. Jameson almost got tagged by Enos Kakia. That's also close. When he throws another contender, it looks like we've got a Lane Motorsports 1-2 right now, with Leland Hill in first, James Jameson second, but I think Enos Kakia. Oh my god, then we got our first caution of the day. Oh my god, what happened this time? Who got involved? Oh, and not bad. I don't think as much damage. Some minor damage from some of the cars. Let's see. Oh, Drew Walker was closed. Camry Jr. got involved. So after three laps, the caution has come. So right now, let's take a look and see what happened. So who actually caused it? Let's see. Ooh, and Jackie Daytona. Oh, and David Dixon got involved as well. Let's take a look again. I can't remember who that is. Oh, and Jackie Daytona. I think he got tagged by Jack Halleck, I think that's what caused it. So we will take a look at it more Anyway, let's see. I think Jack Halleck might have got hit. I don't know if Jackie Daytona. We'll see. I can't see it clearly. Oh, I think Roberto Crown Jr. hitting the wall must have gave Jackie Daytona some sort of reflex and caused him to go out of control. We'll take a look on board and see, but I did see a concerned sight of Roberto Crown Jr. being so wide onto the wall. I think it might have been the steering issue from the 9 car straight from the start. Let's see. Oh, well, they didn't make contact, but Jackie Daytona must have reacted really badly by slamming himself onto the brakes enough to lose control of his car and causing his big bang of a collision. Spectator mode. Will it work or will it not work? I'm trying to get a clearer sight of what's happened. So who else got involved? Jackie Daytona got involved and David Dixon also got involved. Oh, Saber Fox had quite a near miss down there. I think we'll take a look at some onboard cameras. I think that'll be enough. Let's take a look at a couple of onboard cameras. So Saber Fox, who barely just missed it. And the Tari Lowell, who got hit on the side. I don't know how Tari is going to perform, so let's take a look on board. That Jace Tavaglia, does he have a problem? I don't know if he got contacted. Oh, I think he went. I think he did a good job swerving through that massive collision. Is that a huge jump for Tavaglia? I don't think it was a jump. It wasn't much. I thought it felt like a jump to me. Anyway, back to the front and back live. As we go back, Leland Hill continues to lead. And currently we have a 1-2 going on with Leland Hill. And we have pit stops coming in. And it looks like that some cars have decided not to pit, which is quite not ironic, but I guess it's a disadvantage. Oh, Jameson. What's going on with Jameson now this time? Whoa. What happened? Whoa. Jameson slapped right in front of what is going on there. Do we have to restart the race? Because that is unacceptable. Why did they stop? Why did they stop? Why did they swerve? Why didn't they just stop? That's a problem. They went really slow, and was it on board, all aboard the slow train of Angelina Patrick right up front? This looks very concerning. So that certainly is going to. That pretty much that would have ended Jameson's hopes of a championship as a result of this. They went so slow, they have no idea where they're going, and then this caused some other collisions as well. This is a complete mess. What a complete mess we're seeing. So straight from second place, he got taken out. So we'll see if we can restart the race. If we can restart the race, then I'll let you know. Okay, we are back. And so right now, after discussing with the officials about what to do next, we have decided to carry on from there, so the race will not be restarted. So that means, unfortunately, as a result, despite seemingly what I believe isn't at fault for this particular driver, James Jameson, unfortunately, let's take a look at this replay of James Jameson. Unfortunately, as a result of those slow cars who decided not to look where they're going. Oh no, we've seen two championship contenders have literally took themselves out. So that means two drivers are now eliminated from the championship as a result. Definitely for Jameson, who of course you can see him smoking. Now he's definitely out of the running. Oh, and some cars have messed themselves up. But where is Drew Walker? Where is Drew Walker? Need to find him. So Drew Walker, I don't think he's going to make it because now he's got damage at the back. So that's certainly going to be that. Well, I don't know if he's going to carry on racing, but as a result of this, let's take a look at it. So technically, we have two championship contenders. They got taken out by, during the caution as a result. So sort of post-caution madness caused by two contenders. Look at that. It is absolutely insane. So at least one driver has now got taken out completely. Look at Alejo. He's got some damage. This is going to be hard for him as well. I don't know where he sustained it from. He actually hit. Yeah, he bumped right into the back as a result of James Jameson hitting the rear of James Jameson. Sorry, Drew Walker. I'm sorry. I'm a loss of words right now. It is absolutely crazy to see this right now. And is that a glitch? That's a glitch, I can tell. That's no damage or anything from Camera Senior. But, oh boy, I don't know what to say. Don't know what else to say now. So, anyway, let's see. So, Jameson is out. Definitely not going to be able to continue. But Drew Walker, currently in fourth place. So he's currently in danger at the moment. He might be able to try and nurse his car as much as he can possibly can to the front. Well, at least to the end of the race. If he can carry on from there, then hopefully he can try and save himself and secure a place in the final four. So it looks as though that it's going to be really tight here at Homestead. This is going to be even more exciting. So Jameson is confirmed out, followed by Casey Banz and David Dixon. And right now, all right, Alejo, who I just showed you, who actually bumped and sustained a bit of front damage following that unfortunate collision, that pre-caution collision by James Jameson. He's now leading the race. So I think one more lap and then let's stop wasting time. Just one more lap and we're going to go racing again here. Let's see if Alejo can try and make it. This might be critical for Alejo because he's got a bit of damage, but is he going to try and at least hold as much as he can possibly can? We're going great. Oh, and Nick Tander blew up. Nick Tander is out of the race with a blown engine. Nick Tander out of the race with a blown engine. So another retirement of the day. So right now, Alejo has managed to try and hold on to the lead as much as he can possibly go. Oh, another collision has gone on again. Oh, dear me. What happened? Oh, that was close. That was close. They almost got taken out. Roberto Crown Jr., let's take a look at that replay. They literally saved it and literally, there was no caution. They last managed to save it. Let's see what happened. What was it? They got tapped, hit the wall, but they would have kept the car going. That is pretty close. Whoa, pretty close on the number 9 car. Oh dear, Roberto Ground Jr. managed to keep his car going. And there's no caution. I don't think there's no caution. Oh, and it looks as though Emery J. Brown's got some damage. Hold on, yeah, it stopped because I stopped the thingy, though. Yeah, Emery J. Brown has got some rear damage, but we'll... I think I know why. It's probably because of Jameson. That collision obviously decided for... Which obviously decided who's going to make it to the final four, which is certainly not going to be Jameson. Don't know why I keep mentioning Jameson many times. So, anyway, take a look at this very close call on board Roberto Crown Jr., who almost got taken out. Luckily, despite some front damage, was able to keep his car going. How insane that is to see Roberto Crown Jr. saving himself from an unfortunate crash. Could have been another caution, but let's take a look at it again. Yeah, I know it's been slow. It's a slow start. Oops. Whoops-a-daisy. Yeah, a close call. A close call on the 9 car. Now, let's get back to where I'm meant to be, and we will restart the race. Now. So. Oh my. Close shave for the 9 car. Let's see if everyone can try and hold themselves up as much as they can possibly can. Oh, and 5 wide is not looking good. 5 wide is not looking good. I think Lino's going to try and overtake Olejo. Will he try and overtake for the lead? And yeah, Nick Tander trying to nudge his car to the pits, and he's managed to have done so. Oh, look at that. Look at that. And looks as though Lino will try and take the lead from Alejo. Alejo, who was... Yeah, he managed to lead for a couple of laps despite a bit of damage in front of him. Now he's going to try and hold up as much as he can possibly can. It looks as though his chances are now starting to fade a little bit. Now he's got 3 championship contenders up front. I think he's on a much dangerous spot now because he wants to try and at least beat them. And if he don't beat them, then that's going to be bad. Because right now, only Blake Parker, who doesn't need to do anything, because now he's locked onto the final four. And he's right there in around just outside the top 10. And there is Blake Parker. So close calls here at Homestead so far. What an interesting start of the race. And look at these 3 contenders now battling side by side here at Homestead. It is quite good to see these cars battling it out together. And some cars are hitting the wall. Some concern over there. And I think Roberto Crown Jr. sadly looks as though his performance is starting to fall. Since that close call collision, which could have ended in actual collision and a caution, but sadly, that's not to be his day today. So right now, Solomon Sharon is currently leading the race. And we've got Lin Ho in second place, and Dream Meek's trying to take third place. I think she's trying to take second place off of Lin Ho, and he does it without any issue. So Sheridan currently leads. Trey Meeks in second place. And he also wants to win as well. And there's David Ryans. And he will try and overtake Leland Hill for third place. Or if Leland Hill doesn't respond. And oh, close call on David Ryans. Not an actual close call, but he manages to slowly get past the 54 car. And we've got 2 drivers battling it out together for the lead. Leland Hill, not Leland Hill. Solomon Sheridan and Leland Hill. What am I thinking? What am I thinking today? Trey Meeks, not Leland Hill. Trey Meeks in the 6th car and Solomon Sheridan in the 11th car are now battling out together as we come up to lap 15. And I think David Ryan is going to try and join in as well. And Jania Patrick as well, also trying to join in as well. So it looks like a battle. Battle starting to come back again. Lane Hill trying to get past the 72 car of David Ryan's again. So it looks like, I think, based on the life standings, I think Leland Hill could probably at least get in. I think the best bonus of actually getting into the final four would be to actually win the race, which is, I think at the moment he might just be able to just get in, but that will depend on the performances of the other cars in front of him. Of course, Jameson's already out. That's one thing. And but we've got Blake Parker, who's currently another close call from Reynolds and Blake Parker, but they managed to save themselves back. They managed to get themselves back on the track together. As we can see how risky they're all doing here at Homestead. This is what Homestead is all about, taking the risks. And you can see how they're literally racing around like absolute madness of drivers down there. As we're coming up to the lap 20, as Sheridan still leads at the moment, and Lin Ho also in second place, who really wants to win this race. He's been a little down. Obviously, he's currently the last standing driver in the chase, and he really, really wants to keep going. Look at him. He now is trying to get past his former teammate and his former ally, team ally, Trey Meeks. By the time when this series started, Lean's team used to be called Hill Meeks Racing, but now it's called Lean Motorsports. So right now it's all getting a bit quieter now after an explosive start of the race, which ended with another close call, and somehow they're able to keep going. But I would say, another caution. I think Marcus Sanchez almost got tangled with other car. Let's see, look at it again. I think he, and thanks to Jackie D. Turner, they managed to continue. How crazy that is. So close between the two cars. We take a look on board Jackie D. Turner. We can see the moment you might be able to feel the impact of Jackie D. Turner getting bumped onto its side. I think it's better if I go on board Marco Sanchez. We'll be able to tell from there. You can see Marco Sanchez. Yeah, close call. Anyway, quickly back to the front. And so far, it's all still looking good. Getting a bit cleaner. We have now concerns that Drew Walker could end up being lapped down. So unfortunately, I guess Drew Walker will be next to be out of the chase following that collision with James Jameson. So yeah, as I can say, effectively, we have two contenders taken out. That's quite rare to see in a while's time. Two championship contenders took themselves out. That was because of the caution, due to the fact that they're trying to get themselves together. Unfortunately, ended up in shambles. So right now, look at it. There's Riley Hill joining in, and David Rines and Zach Campbell also joining in for the battle for second place now. They're going three wide for the second place, as it looks as though that Sheridan is going to try and overtake or try and get past Drew Walker, which is going to be very unfortunate to see. Let's see, look at how the hero is fading right now. Drew Walker is fading out. As Solomon Sheridan gets past Solomon Sheridan, so Drew Walker is now a lap down. Not Drew Walker. Trey Meeks is getting Trey Meeks just got passed. Now he's falling behind. He got passed by four lap cars. And now he's trying to get himself back up the front, as Lane Hill also gets past Drew Walker. He just needs to carry on from there. He probably try and win the race, which would be a big bonus for him. And Drew Walker. It's not Drew Walker. Why am I making mistakes with driving? Oh, and we've got another collision. Thanks a lot. Drew Walker looks as though that will be the end of his day. He ends his championship hopes with a literal bang. You can see how he was literally fading down in the race, unfortunately. ended up in a bang. I don't think he's going to be able to continue. So unfortunately, he decides to just end it all by causing a collision with Bradley Rehm. And I think Talon Soplu also got involved. Oh wait, he's able to continue going. So lap 27 it is. And yeah, we have another caution caused by Drew Walker. We'll take a look closer at Talon Soplu. Talon Soplu managed to get himself back onto the track, but Bradley Rehm obviously lost control and ended himself up onto the wall. Anyway, on board Talon Soplu in that ginormous, gigantic scheme, which is, of course, you can see it's an Eggman Robotnik scheme, in his new 92 car, who he finally gets a proper number for the rest of this season. And you can see in the moment of impact, he took out, well, you can see Drew Walker getting taken out. I think Drew Walker went a bit wide. Yeah, I think Drew Walker went a bit wide onto the wall and then didn't see where he was going. I think it's more due to the fact that he lost control of his car. He couldn't get his car under control properly. So now, we'll take a look on board Drew Walker as we see another man going down. Two men down, six more to go. As Drew Walker, who is most likely going to lose his hopes of a championship, unless he does a Jay Chevalier or something and get his lap back or something, but otherwise it does not seem likely. So now we see we can go on board Bradley Rehm. Where is Bradley Rehm? There is Bradley Rehm. We go on board Bradley Rehm. I think Bradley Rehm luckily had no damage, and I don't think Talon Soplu sustained damage as well. The damage is mostly sustained by Drew Walker. Oh, a bit of damage by Bradley Rehm, who got a bit of side damage, but I don't think that would affect him much. So now we go back to the front as Sheridan continues to lead. Let's hope we get more action from there. Interesting race going along with lots of good old actions, and ooh, more drivers are pitting. Sheridan decides to pit, but Leland Hill decides to stay out. This is interesting. Some drivers decide to gamble for better tires, but Leland Hill decides to stay out. So I don't know if they're going to come in for their pit stop. We'll have to see. And they're not going to pit, so I guess that means that they decide to focus on their older tires, which I don't think is going to be ideal, because these tires could probably last less than compared to the others, because they've got newer tires now and they're going to try and get back towards the front. So right now, as we take a look at the standings again, we'll take a look one more time at the lower standings live at the moment. As we see, Drew Walker seems as though that his day and his hopes are for a championship are completely done, even though he's just a lap down and still in the running in the race. But right now, the race is go once again. Oh, Brad Carker almost got tagged by David Ryan's. Oh, and that could have been another collision. And right now, it looks as though the sum of the car they're trying to get back. Sheridan decided to make a second pit stop. And Roberto Crown Jr., obviously, with that close call earlier on in the race. Leland Hill is now taking the lead. He's now in the lead as a result. Oh, and another five wide there. That's not looking good. It looks pretty risky to see this. Every time I see them going five wide, it makes my heart beat right now. some cars are hitting the wall, something else to keep an eye on. Like what happened with Roberto Crane Jr., who obviously caused that earlier collision, the early collision. And I think Leland Hill's right there, and he wants to lead the race. Look at him. Look at him. It's not looking good. It's not looking good. Something's going to happen. Really bad. Some cars are quite lucky with damage. They're able to try and keep themselves going as well. Probably due to the fact that some cars have made the pit stop, the second pit stop, but they haven't. So I think they're just trying to gamble with their lives and so on. But oh, Blake Parker hit the wall. You can see Blake Parker. Oh, and it's not look almost another collision. That is Flandre Wilson. I think she almost got taken out by Jonah Burridge. And they almost lost it, which is really quite close. Quite close to see it to Homestead again. Homestead obviously is starting to become like Homestead now. More action going along. Look at all these cars literally fighting against one another. As you can see, it appears to me that they're making a lot of contact. And Sheridan trying to get back towards the front. We don't know where Trey Meeks is. Trey Meeks is just right there, but he is trying to push himself back towards the front. Oh, Trey Meeks almost lost it on the 92 car. Trey Meeks also almost lost on the 92 car. This could have been another contender taken out if this happened. Look at Trey Meeks. He almost took out another driver. The battle is simply heating on right now. Literally heating up right now. As Leland Hill continues to lead, I think Sheridan is trying to get himself back up. We can see that his new tires is literally working for him. Now he's back in the top five. And Trey Meeks is now trying to get himself back up as well. And I think Alright Alejo might be the driver as well to join in as well. I think he's literally trying to hold on as much as he can possibly can. I think Alejo is right there. I don't know who is the other car that who's the other driver that is currently in the running as well. I almost forgot. Dylan Hayden. And he's right there. Just right behind Alejo. In fact, I think they're equal on points, so if one of them goes in front, then they have more of a chance. Ooh, Enos Kakia almost got taken out as well. Another close call for Enos Kakia. Where on earth did it happen? Sheridan! Caused Enos Kakia to almost got taken out. Almost hit the wall. And then trying to get himself back in. But oh, now Enos Kakia almost trying to get his revenge on the 11 car. Despite the fact that he's not a contender himself. I think Sheridan is getting really impatient right now. Oh, was there another close call? I didn't see that. Let me take a look at the last lap. Let's see. Go quickly. Oh. I felt something was going on, but yeah, nothing happened. Anyway. So Solomon Sheridan now trying to get past the 72 car. David Ryans. As Sophia Petty, I think she's got some damage, I think. No, she's really slow. She's really slow. In the Camry James car. As now, we're back to... Oh, and what's happened at the back as well? It's always risky when someone goes wide and they appear to be three wide. Five wide, I mean. One of the cars hit the wall. Now is, of course, Rally Hill. This is going to be really tight now for the chase. It is truly a fight to the final four right now. as Leland Hill hopefully to win the race. He's in a much comfortable spot now. If he can win this race, he'll be on a more guaranteed spot. But right now, he's got Simon Sheridan chasing him right now. Let's take a look on board as we are set to pass Drew Walker for the second time. As we can see him in the picture, Drew Walker's championships hopes, as I keep saying, is definitely out for this season 2 champion. Well, I can say what a race we're seeing right now. We've already gone past the halfway mark. Oh, will this change everything? Could this be Drew Walker's revenge again? If this happens with those drivers, this would have been the worst. Oh, and someone almost got wide again. This time on Dex Miyazaki and Talon Soplu and the Odita Baggers. They went so close, three wide together. As we go back to the front, I think Drew Walker now decides to just let it slide from there. Yeah, Drew Walker, yeah, is not able to defend his position. Now he's a lap down already. So now Sheridan up into the lead. Well, did Sheridan took the lead from Leland Hill because of Drew Walker, I think. Yeah, I think so. I probably just missed that. And you can see the overtaking move on Sheridan. Thanks to Drew Walker. I think that's some sort of a teamwork effort because they're actually both teammates. So I guess Leland Hill just got wooed by CD Motorsports with Drew Walker blocking him. And that gave Sheridan the chance of an overtake for the lead. And Eddie Flores Jr. joins in for the battle as he lines up behind the two. And Leland Hill's going to try again on the 11 car, but will he try and defend that position? Because he's on older tires. He's like 20 laps older, the tires are, compared to Simon Sheridan's tires. I don't know if Eddie Flores Jr. had made a pit stop, I think. But his tires seem to be really good as well. So Leland Hill will try and take the lead and take in Eddie Flores Jr. with him. But I think Sheridan is trying to fight back for the lead. And Saber Fox as well joins in on the battle as well, as Eddie Flores Jr. starts to fade a little bit. Owen Cameron Sr. is out of the race with a suspension failure. We will take a look at what happened to Sr. I don't know if it might be an engine blowout or he just stopped on the track. But we'll take a look at Cameron Sr. right now. Let's see what happened to Sr. Not much to worry about because he's not a contender at the moment. Oh, he came into the pits. I think he had problems during the caution and he decided to come to the pits, and for some reason he had to retire. That was just after the restart. Now back to the front as Sheridan is still leading at the moment. I think Trey Mix is trying to fight back now with newer tires, trying to do the same as what Sheridan just did. He is fighting back. And then he's now up into fifth place. Yeah, I didn't put the volume up as much, but hopefully that doesn't affect anyone's enjoyment of watching the race. Trey Meeks up into third place. So I think, as it stands, I think Blake Parker, who is obviously locked in, will make it onto the chain. And I think it's going to be between Sheridan, Lane Hill, and Trey Meeks. I think four drivers, as it stands at the moment, I think those four drivers would have made it to the chase, to the final four, if the race would have ended now. Which is going to be pretty interesting to see. I don't know how much, I don't know how long Leland Hill is, but I'm starting to question Leland Hill's position. Maybe he might just make it because now he's on a very high position. But depending on the other drivers' performance, especially in the, especially the ones behind the cutoff line, the likes of Alejo, who of course was somewhat affected, and he's right there in the 22nd place, I don't think he will be able to make it. Because he's got some damage. And of course, with Jameson and Juwoko already out of the running, and Dylan as well, he's near the edge of the points in 26th place, so I don't think he's going to make it either. So that would mean, looking at it, as I keep saying again, Sheridan, Lean Hill, Trey Meeks, and Blake Parker will be the final four. But we've got a few more laps to go. And right now, Sheridan is continuing to lead. He's continuing to lead. I'm bad at pronunciation today because I'm so tired. And Sheridan is continuing to dominate. And looks like Roberto Crown Jr. will be another driver to get past. He's already a lap down. Is he a lap? No, he's not a lap. He's not a lap down. But it could. He could get lapped before the end of the race. Hopefully this doesn't mess up the drivers' performance. Or could it be? Could this be another opportunity for some other driver to try and battle for the lead coming up to the last lap of the race? Coming up to the closing lap of the race, at least. It looks like Saber Fox is trying to battle alongside Trey Meeks with ease, at least. We have got five laps to go, and it's all looking good. Oh, and we've got two cars lapped, or set to be lapped, now in the way of the leaders. And now, it's going to be Drew Walker who will be the driver to deal with now. So this is probably going to be decided by this guy, Drew Walker, who is already out of the running. Let's hope he doesn't do the exact same thing as what he did during the last caution. Sort of trying to take someone's revenge for doing something. Oh, and he does it with ease. Only because Sheridan is right there and he doesn't want to mess up his teammate. I don't know. Could be a revenge on some other driver. Some random revenge. Oh, and looks as though Leland Hill is getting close and close and close. Now, it's going to be interesting who's actually going to win the race. It's probably going to be between those two, as it looks as though that the other cars are now falling behind, and now the 3-1. Ooh, it's going to be close. What happened? I feel smoke. Is that a caution? It is a caution, and that will effectively end the race. Oh my gosh, Leland Hill's got it! I think he's won it! Leland Hill just won the race! Thanks to cautions, he's done it! Leland Hill is in the running for the championship, definitely, thanks to the lap car and, of course, the caution. Oh, dear. What on earth did I just saw right now? We have another race to remember, as the race ended in a caution and Roberto Crown Jr. just gifted the win to Leland Hill, and it's so close to see Sheridan almost, he was dominating for much of the race until unfortunately lost at the last minute. Flandre Wilson got spun out by Nicholas Wright. Not any damage sustained from that collision, but that triggered the caution. And Patrick Thompson, I don't know what happened to Patrick Thompson. Let's see what happened. I don't know. They were pitting. I guess some drivers who didn't pit during the second caution, fortunately, didn't make it. But despite Sheridan, who pitted two times, I think he pitted twice compared to Leland Hill's one-stop strategy, and decided not to carry on. He decided not to pit. And yeah, he decided not to pit during the second caution. Despite that, he was able to literally overhaul Sheridan for the lead just right on time. I can't believe it. It just literally blew my mind off. We have seen an absolute race. Oh, and a close finish as well. Or could have been a photo finish, but I think we call it a photo finish because this happened under caution. Look at that. Call it the closest race. I don't think it's the closest. Compare this with Atlanta. Sorry, what's going on with me today? I need to start taking rest earlier on in the day because I'm so knackered, but also my mind's completely blown up to see what race we've delivered today. What a race we've delivered today. Maybe I'll look at it on another angle, but oh boy, that was an interesting close finish between Sheridan and Hill. Thanks to Roberto Crown Jr., the lap call decided to deliver something even more. In fact, he was quite a driver that can make anyone's day. In fact, this made the whole race literally for what happened just after the first caution, who almost had a close call onto the wall and somehow didn't trigger the yellow flag. He was able to keep his car going. Well, now this is the last lap and now we shall all confirm the results. So Leland Hill first, Sheridan second, Trey Meeks third, fourth Sabre Fox, fifth Xander House, sixth David Rans, seventh Talon Soplu, eighth Jimmy Irvin, ninth Angelina Patrick, and tenth Olivia Reynolds. What a race to remember. Homestead is a race to remember. And the fastest lap time will go to Solomon Sheridan, 28.302. So that means I think I can tell who is going to make it to the final four. As I keep saying again, I must have said it once before, or maybe twice. So Leland Hill locks into the final four with Blake Parker, and that means likely Trey Meeks and Solomon Sheridan will also advance on to the final four. So this is it. This is definitely, unless I'm wrong and I've not heard anything else, then do count me wrong. Do make me retract absolutely anything I said. whatever you think I'm wrong at. But anyways, what a hell of a race. It wasn't as much as you see as you just saw. There wasn't a lot of collisions. There was just two collisions. There were two cautions basically. But still though, there were a lot of actions. And well, here we go. So that would be Leland Hill's sixth win of this season. Is it going to be a record breaking seventh win, or did he actually broke the record? I think he broke the record. I don't know if he's broke the record for six wins. I could be wrong, but I will double check that later on. So congrats to Leland Hill, a close win for Leland Hill. Thanks to Roberto Crown Jr. and a caution. So thank you everyone for watching this race. We will definitely be looking forward to the last race of the season. So thank you everyone once again. We hope to deliver another what will probably be a greater race than ever, probably better than this one. That will be at the Auto Club. So as I keep saying, thank you everyone for watching this race. We will see you all back on the track very, very, very soon.